First, let me see into the question. A horizontal water jet with a velocity of 25 meters per second. Velocity is given as 25 meters per second. And cross-sectional area A is 30 millimeters square. Strikes a flat plate held normal to the flow direction. The density of water, rho, is given as 1000 kg per cubic meter. The total force on the plate due to the jet is, we have to find out the total force. So by using momentum equation in the normal direction, that is horizontal direction, then theta is equal to 0. So the momentum equation is going to give minus Rn is the normal reaction on the fluid is equal to rho q into 0 minus v cos theta. That implies Rn is equal to rho q v cos theta. Theta is 0, so cos theta is equal to 1. So Rn is equal to rho q v. Rho is 1000 kg per cubic meter and q can be written as A into V. That implies A is 30 millimeter square into 10 to the power of minus 6 meter square into V is 25 square. That implies 18.75 newtons. So option B is correct. What is the discharge corresponding to the critical depth of 1.2 meter? Critical depth is equal to 1.2 meter is given of a rectangular channel of width 3 meters. The width of the rectangular channel is given as 3 meters. So we have to find out the discharge Q. We know the relationship for a rectangular channel, the critical depth is equal to Q square discharge per meter width into G, gravity, whole power 1 by 3. By putting these values over here, we get Yc is 1.2 and Q is equal to Q by B. That is equal to QB. From this, we will get Q is equal to 4.117 meter cube per second. We know the width, that is equal to B. As we can say, Q is equal to 4.117 into 3. That implies 12.352 cubic meters per second. 12.352 is option B is correct. Question we have to do, matching of list 1 with the list 2. So if you know anything, if we see the Manning's roughness coefficient is going to be in open channel flow. So S is directly related to 3. If you see the options, S is 3 is in 2 options. And R, if you see Coriolis coefficient is going to be in velocity distribution. So R is 2R matching. R is 2 in these two options is C. So option C is correct. We can see the other two options, the other two options also. Koslow's curve is to predict weirs and barrages, and Gumbel's method is used to prediction of the flood peaks. So option C is correct. Question is, the dissolved oxygen DO in an unseeded sample of diluted waste having an initial DO of 8.5 milligrams per liter, initial DO YI, we can say final DO YF, that is 8.5 milligrams per liter, and to be 2.5 milligrams per meter after 5 days, that is 2.5 milligrams per liter. So DO consumed is 8.5 minus 2.5, that is equal to 6. We can say it as DO consumed, that is equal to 6 milligrams per liter. the dilution factor is given as dilution factor is 0.03, and the rate reaction rate constant, that K is 0.22 per day. So we have to find out first BOD after 5 days. BOD after 5 days, that is Y5, that is DO consumed by dilution factor. That implies DO consumed 6 by dilution factor 0.03. That implies 200 milligrams per liter. But what we have to find out is ultimate carbonaceous BOD. Ultimate carbonaceous BOD Y5, ultimate carbonaceous BOD L we can represent is 1 minus 10 to the power of minus KD into T. We have to find out KD. KD is equal to 0.434 into K. K is reaction rate constant. That is equal to 0.434 into 0.22. That implies 0.095 per day. By substituting these values in the above equation, we will get ultimate carbonaceous BODL. That implies BOD at 5 days is 200. That is equal to L into 1 minus 10 to the power of minus 0.095 into T is 5 days. Ultimate carbonaceous BOD L is equal to 300 milligrams per liter. That implies option B is correct. We have to find out the error in horizontal circle reading of this and vertical circle reading of this for any point due to the trunnion axis not being perpendicular to the vertical axis by 90 minus I degrees, where I is 20 seconds. So we know that the error in horizontal circle reading is equal to I tan H. I we know 20 seconds tan H. That is equal to 20 seconds into tan 36 degrees 52 minutes down 0.36 seconds. That implies plus 15 seconds. The error in vertical circle reading is negligible. That is, the vertical circle reading error is negligible. So option A is correct. Option is, in a triangulation survey, the altitudes of two stations A and B 110 kilometers apart or respectively 440 and 725 is given. If the Earth's mean radius is 6400 kilometers is given. R is equal to 6400 kilometers is given. And the mean coefficient of refraction is 0.07. That is, mean coefficient of refraction 0.07 is given. What is the distance of visible horizon from A? We have to find out this thing. So, horizon distance is D. The altitude at A is equal to visible horizon distance from A by 2R. R is radius of Earth. 1 minus 2m. By substituting these values in this equation, we can find out D is equal to 3.85794 root H kilometers. That is equal to 3.85794 root H is 440 meters. That is equal to 80.92 kilometers. Option C is correct.